Chapter 81, The Header. The Life and Mission of Joseph Smith. The Rise and Fall of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. The church splits into two factions, according to Satan's desires. The three Nephites are introduced and will aid Joseph and Christopher in their missions. Christopher will have the power to confound those who mock the word of God. 1. And it shall come to pass that the Lord shall instruct those in the spirit world to prepare the first of these final two prophets who shall bring forth the words of this record unto the world. 2. And from the time of his birth, Joseph shall be watched over by those in the spirit world, who will assure that the experiences of his youth shall sufficiently prepare him to have the necessary characteristics and attributes that he will need to fulfill the mission that shall be required of him. 3. And it was determined by the Lord that Joseph should be born into a poor family, who shall live among the people of the states that shall be established among this great nation of the United States of which I have written. 4. And it shall be in his youth that Joseph shall begin to be prepared to be the first of these final prophets of the latter days. 5. And before Joseph is born, an elder brother according to the flesh shall be born unto his father, and prepared also by the Lord to learn those things of his family, and that he might learn of their ways and their customs, so that he might assist in the education and inspiration of his mortal brother. 6. And the Lord shall prepare his brother in this thing, and command that Joseph shall not come into mortality until his brother reacheth an age of responsibility and understanding, so that he might know and remember all things concerning the mission and life of his younger brother Joseph. 7. And in the 8th year of the life of his elder brother, Joseph shall be born into the world. 8. And now it shall be a tradition among the children of men at this time, that the father give unto his oldest son, who is his firstborn, his own name, thus passing on this name through the lineage of his posterity. 9. But the father of Joseph shall not give his name to his oldest son, who shall be called Alvin, who is the one who hath been chosen to assist in the care of Joseph, and to his next son he shall not give his name. But the Lord hath given commandments to those in the spirit world to assure that his next son, who would be the prophet Joseph, should receive his name. 10. And it shall also be customary at this time that the children of men be given a last name, which will distinguish them from others who have also been given the same first name at birth. 11. And there shall be many names among the people at this time. But the last name of this first of the two final prophets shall be a very common name among the people, that he might not stand out, even as the name Jesus was given unto the Christ, that it might be known unto the world that he was born among common men, so that the words of the prophets might be fulfilled when they wrote, saying, 12. For ye see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, and not many mighty, and not many noble, are called of God to preach his words. But God hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and he hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and the base things which are despised hath God chosen, yea, and things which are not glorified by the flesh, to bring to naught things that are glorified by God, that no flesh should glory in his presence. 13. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom, and righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption, so that according as it is written, he that glorieth, let him glory in the Lord. 14. And now Joseph shall grow in the spirit of the Lord in his youth, and Alvin shall be there at his side all the days of his youth to encourage him, and give unto him strength in that which he hath been called to do. 15. And the spirit of Alvin shall be commanded to return to the spirit world, where he might better inspire his brother. But he shall remain upon the earth in mortality with Joseph, until the time that Joseph shall be ready and accepted as a mature adult among the rest of the people of this nation in which he shall be born. 16. And after Joseph hath reached nigh unto the age of 18, then shall Alvin be called back into the spirit world to aid in his instruction and care there. 17. And it shall come to pass that the people of the United States shall begin to exercise the freedom that they have been granted, to set up many religions and faiths according to the dictates of their own consciences, not being afraid to express that which their spirit speaketh unto them. 18. And this was the thing that Satan wanted of the Father, so that he could have more opportunity to bring the children of men to his plan. And Satan began to create a great excitement of religious thought among the people. 19. And with this excitement, the people of the United States shall begin to establish these religions in such a way that the people shall be divided greatly in that which they believe. 20. And this division causeth the love of all men to wax cold, and there shall be great contentions among them, and much confusion as one church attempteth to gain converts from another by the preaching and flattering words of its ministers and its priests. 21. And none of these shall follow the words of Christ, in that they should love one another as they would have another love them. But every priest shall contend against another, in hopes that he might convince the people to join his church and listen to his words and interpretations of the word of God, which the people shall accept in the Bible, which are the words that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Jew, as spoken by the words of Nephi. 22. And the Spirit shall bear down greatly upon Joseph in the days of his youth, and cause him to seek for the truth in all things. 23. But he shall not find this truth in the religions of men that are set up before him, nor shall he be taught this truth by his father Joseph or by his mother, both of them differing in their own opinions, even as the parents of Muhammad, who shall be the last prophet of God, who shall be called forth by and through the holy order of the Son of God before Joseph. 24. And the course of his inquiry of truth shall be the same as that which Muhammad shall follow to find the truth for himself, and in the same manner in which Muhammad shall be given instruction and revelation from God, so shall Joseph be given this knowledge of God through the same means. 25. Behold, the Father and the Son shall also reveal themselves unto Joseph, and manifest the actuality of their beings unto him, that he might no longer live by faith in this thing, and also that he might not be deceived by the words and precepts of those men who think they are learned, and who think that they know the will and mind of God concerning that which the Father would have his children know of him during the days of their probations upon the earth. 26. And the Lord shall command Joseph to hide the true nature of the visitation that he shall receive from the Father and the Son, until he hath established the means whereby the fullness of his gospel might come forth unto the children of men. 27. And the Lord shall suffer once again that a church be established among the Gentiles, that they might have an opportunity to know the true gospel of Jesus Christ, and have the truth of all things taught to them by the Spirit of God, once they have perfected their lives to such a degree that the Spirit is able to bear its witness unto them. 28. And if the children of men were righteous, then they would have the Spirit to teach unto them all things that would lead them safely down the straight and narrow path which leadeth to eternal life and happiness. 29. But the children of men have never been of such a righteous state that they could have the great blessing of the Spirit. 30. And for this purpose the Lord shall suffer that Joseph establish a church in the latter days, that these things might more easily be accepted by those who are accustomed to receiving their instruction from God, from a church, or from a man, or a prophet, who shall be likened to Moses. 31. Now, I have already explained unto you that this is not the way that the Lord would teach us his ways, but he suffereth it because of your wickedness in denying the power of the Holy Spirit, and in not keeping the commandments which are given in the words and gospel of Christ. 32. And the Father shall allow the rising up of this latter-day church, so that he can show by an example the great weakness and frailties of the children of men in complying with his plan while they choose to follow the course which Satan has set for them. 33. For ye cannot serve God and mammon. He who hath ears that hear, let him understand. 34. And it shall come to pass that this church, which shall be established by Joseph, shall be established in righteousness in the beginning. 35. And after it hath been established in righteousness, the people of the church shall begin to rebel against Joseph. And when they shall begin to rebel against this prophet of God, the church that was suffered by the Lord to be built up for the sanctification and instruction of the saints of God and its authority shall be taken from the earth. 36. And in its stead there shall rise up two more churches, which shall both claim the power and authority that the Lord gave unto Joseph in the beginning to establish a church of God among the people. 37. But the Lord shall take the power and authority of the priesthood, which is after his holy order, from off the earth when the first church shall be destroyed. And this power and authority to establish a righteous church shall not be given again unto the children of men upon the earth. 38. And Satan shall take the remnants of the church of God, and they shall be under his power. And he shall see which church shall give unto him his authority. Or in other words, which church shall seek after the things of the world and the pride and honor of the men of the earth. 39. And there shall be one of these two that shall rise up above all other churches of the latter days. Nevertheless, it shall not rise up in righteousness, but in wickedness. For those who shall belong to this church shall also belong to the church of the devil and desire the blessings of this great and abominable church. 40. And ye shall witness hereafter in this record the rise of this great church which shall be called the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And ye shall see the way in which Satan in subtleness overcometh this church and taketh control of its leaders, so that it becometh a powerful church that shall wield the power that it shall receive from Satan, who shall be its God and its Christ. 41. But in the beginning it was not so. And I have shown unto you that the record of my father shall come forth unto Joseph, and he shall translate the part which is unsealed, and publish it to the world, so that all might know of the work of the father, which was wrought upon the land of Eden, which is this promised land, which shall be called in the latter days the United States of America. 42. And the unsealed portion of this record shall come forth by the power of God, which the Lord hath promised unto me, that I might be the protector and overseer of these plates, that they might not fall into the hands of the wicked and be destroyed. 43. And it shall come to pass that I shall die, and then, according to the promise that the Lord gave unto me when he was in my presence, immediately I shall resurrect and go to the kingdom of the Father and receive the glory that I have desired for myself. 44. And then the Lord shall command me that I should watch over the work that shall come forth from my own hand unto Joseph. 45. And there shall be others who are not exalted, even those three apostles who were among those whom the Lord called forth when he visited my people in the land of Bountiful. 46. And these three shall be upon the earth until the end of time, and they shall not be known among men, having hidden themselves from the sight of men all the days of their lives. 47. Now, I say hidden because they disguise themselves, and act in a way that others shall not discover who they are, so that they might oversee the work of the Lord in all things in the latter days. 48. And my father was forbidden to write their names in the record that was unsealed, but in this record their names are given, and these are the brother of Nephi, who was named Timothy, whose body was transformed at the time he was raised from the dead by the word of Nephi, and also Matthani, and his brother Matthaniha. Yea, these are those apostles who remain upon the earth in a state of mortality, but cannot grow old, having received this blessing according to their desires of the Lord. 49. And they shall give much strength to these last two latter-day prophets, who shall bring forth this record unto the people of the earth. 50. For behold, I shall not be able to abide upon the earth once I have brought forth this record unto Joseph, who is the first among them, because I shall have an exalted body of flesh and bone like unto the Father in that day. And because of the body that I shall possess at that time, I cannot sojourn among them and give them assistance at that time. 51. But I shall come down at the set time of the Lord, when the prophet Joseph shall be ready to receive the record that my father and I have prepared according to the commandments of the Lord. 52. And I shall instruct Joseph in many things, and teach him many things concerning this record, and the way in which it should be translated and come forth unto the world. 53. And I shall command him to not break the bands which I shall make to seal this portion of the record concerning the vision of the brother of Jared. And this portion of the record shall contain the mysteries of God that he would have his children know in the last days of the half of time, which is the end of the time before he shall send his son in all of his glory to reign upon the earth. 54. And Joseph shall prepare the world to receive these things which are sealed. And he shall take part in the coming forth of this sealed portion, even by bringing the plates which have been made by my own hands and the hands of my father, and delivering them unto the last of these final prophets, whose name beareth the name of Christ. 55. And it shall come to pass that in the very same year that Joseph shall establish the church of God in the last days, yea, in this same year shall begin the half of times of which I have spoken. 56. And in the same month as the birth of Muhammad, which was the mark of the end of the times, shall this church be presented to the world as the only true church of God upon the earth. 57. And now, these times and events are given unto you who lack faith and do not believe in these things. For there shall be many of you who shall mock these last prophets, and shall say that of themselves these things have come forth from their own hand, that the children of men might be deceived. 58. And I say unto you, woe unto you who shall say these things, and shall lead others to believe in your words. For do ye not also have the Bible with you? And would ye convince others that these last two prophets wrote the Bible also? 59. Yet, in this record shall all the signs of the great revelations be revealed unto you, which are given by the prophets of God in the Bible. 60. And when ye have an explanation of the symbolism and the allegories that were given in the words of the ancient prophets of God, will ye then say that these two prophets have invented these things to deceive you? 61. And as ye read the words of this record, behold, what do these words say unto you? Do they not make an attempt to push you towards Christ, and to love your neighbor as yourself, and to forsake the world, and become one with the Father in all things? 62. Yea, ye know that they preach these things, for this is the only message of God that should be taught among you. And those of you who have received these things, and who doubt within yourself of whence they came, yea, have ye read all of these words? 63. Yea, have ye spoken to the last of these two latter-day prophets about these things? Can ye confound him in his words? I say unto you, that ye cannot confound him in his words, because he speaks according to the Spirit of God, which is within him. And he who speaketh according to the Spirit of God cannot be confounded in that which he speaketh. 64. But ye who condemn them, and who believe that these things were invented by them that they might deceive you, why do ye not speak with the prophet of God that is now among you upon the earth? 65. Behold, I shall prophesy unto you, and tell you why ye do not speak to him. Yea, Satan hath great power over your hearts, and ye are filled with anger and hate towards him, even with the same anger and the hate that the Jews had against Jesus when he spoke unto them. 66. And Satan shall inspire you to not seek out this last prophet and speak to him of these things. For Satan knoweth that he shall confound you in your words, And if ye are confounded in your words, then what shall ye say of your understanding and your knowledge and the spirit which ye harbour inside of you? 67. Behold, ye shall go away knowing that ye do not know truth, and ye shall be empty and afraid to speak unto this latter day prophet, even as ye shall be afraid to be in the presence of the Lord, and listen to his words when he cometh in his glory. 68. And ye shall seek to kill this prophet, and rid the world of him, because he condemneth you in your wickedness, and casteth down your pride and your arrogance in those things which ye think ye understand of God. 69. And when the Lord cometh in his glory, and calleth forth the plates of ore that my father and I have made with our own hands, yea, and ye have the Urim and Thummim explained and shown unto you, then what shall ye say? 70. Will ye look upon the Lord and say unto him, we do not believe these things, for they came forth from the writings of a man? 71. Behold, in that day when all the books shall be opened unto you, those of you who have doubted these things shall be ashamed and disgraced in the glory that ye have received from Satan in the church of the devil to which ye belong. End of chapter 81.